John McAfee was a genius, scoundrel, software pioneer, crypto supporter, gun fanatic, international fugitive, and one of the most controversial figures in tech history. Since Wednesday, new reports have surfaced about his incredible, often chaotic life, and new developments have arisen regarding the truth about his death, including his wife Janet McAfee, who says that he was not suicidal and is demanding a thorough investigation. John McAfee's body was found in his cell at a Barcelona prison shortly after a Spanish court approved his extradition to the United States, where he faced multiple charges for allegedly pumping dubious cryptocurrency ventures. His death has initially been labeled as a suicide by the Catalonia Regional Government Justice Department, which manages the prisons there. John McAfee, of course, was the founder of the famous antivirus software firm, which he was no longer affiliated with. The United States Department of Justice alleges that he participated in a scheme that earned him and a partner $13 million by falsely promoting cryptocurrencies to unwitting investors, which led to a tax evasion charge. The final two decades of McAfee's life were chaotic and included a bizarre series of events no one could have anticipated. In 2012, John McAfee disappeared briefly after local police in Belize attempted to question him regarding the death of his neighbor. He fled, later claiming that he did so because he feared for his life and denying any involvement. McAfee sought asylum in Guatemala before moving to Montreal, Canada, and working on a documentary about his life. He then announced a run for president of the United States in 2016 as a libertarian, and although ultimately unsuccessful, he gained a fair amount of traction. Despite his multiple arrests and controversial actions, he remained a popular figure in the tech world for his outspoken and firm stances on everything from data privacy and excessive surveillance to adamant criticism of the US government. And that's exactly where his widowed wife is pointing the finger for his death. When speaking to reporters, Janice McAfee said this:
John McAfee was not suicidal. I spoke with him a few hours before he was found dead. We spoke about the court's decision to extradite him to the U.S. It did not come as a surprise to either of us. We were prepared for that decision and had a plan of action already in place to appeal that decision. I blame the U.S. authorities for this tragedy. Because of these politically motivated charges against him, my husband is now dead. He would never quit this way. He would never take his life in this way.
Things get even more complicated when you take into account this tweet from John McAfee himself from November of 2019 that reads, "Getting subtle messages from US officials saying, in effect, we're coming for you, McAfee. We're going to kill yourself. I got a tattoo today just in case. If I suicide myself, I didn't. I was whacked. Check my arm." The Superior Court of Catalonia says the cause of McAfee's death is currently under investigation. Janice McAfee's lawyer, Javier Villalba, told reporters on Friday that his client is waiting for the official autopsy to be completed, adding that the family has requested a second independent one. Only time will tell what the autopsies reveal, and the only thing that's certain about McAfee's death right now is uncertainty. What we can say for sure is that this is an important historical moment, and that McAfee's death was just as controversial as his life. Thank you for watching, everyone. What are your thoughts on the life and death of John McAfee? Please let me know in the comments down below. And if you enjoyed this video and want to support independent tech journalism, please consider subscribing to BTC Pro. Thanks again.